Because my heart can pound like thunder. Okay, scalpel, please. Scalpel. If you're not going to do your job and cooperate, then get out. Keep her stable. I got the call. Code red, is it? I've had to leave the patient with an associate. Where do you need me?
You need to stand down.
What about the motorway crash?
An orthopedic surgeon was scheduled. You're an oncologist. You aren't qualified.
Excuse me? There is no emergency, is there?
You shouldn't be in there. It's a major breach of protocol.
And you think dragging me out of a surgery on a fake code red isn't a major protocol breach?
If you go back in there, I'll report you.
And I will sue you for harassment. Now, I'm going to have to scrub in again. And every minute of my time that you and everyone else around here deems fit to waste is just prolonging that poor girl's surgery.
What are you doing? It isn't right.
You need to seriously rethink your choices, Miss Lomax. Otherwise, your sad crusade of a career will be over. Because if you think I can't make your life difficult, then you are very wrong.
You have bullied and cowed the staff at this hospital into a procedure that you had no authority to carry out.
And you have jeopardized an operation that was under control. And who says I've bullied them? This is just a figment of your twisted imagination.
You threatened Perry.
I know you're upset that your case got thrown out by the court, but has it really come to this?
You shouldn't have been operating in a trauma setting.
I stepped in when no one else was available. You should be thanking me.
What you did was unethical. And I will not stand by and allow you to gratify your ego yet again. The orthopedic surgeon is here, and the surgical team have said they do not support you continuing this surgery.
This is insubordination! If anything happens to that poor girl, it'll be your fault.
No, Ali. You had to play the hero. And now Serena's athletics career could be over before it's even started.
Dawn, I'm glad you're here. I have some concerns over the handling of the Chen Williams operation. I mean, I never would have agreed to do the surgery under any other circumstances.
Misbah has already informed me.
Yeah, well, Misbah has a version of events.
You operated outside your area of expertise. You know what this means?
Don't I get to put my side forward?
It amounts to assault.
I had to make a split decision under very difficult circumstances. I did what any doctor would do. I did what I thought was right.
Which suggests a serious error in judgment. You have compromised the reputation of this hospital, never mind your own. I strongly suggest you get back in touch with your lawyer. We're going to have to do a full investigation.
I know what you're doing. You're blaming me for botching the job because of your personal vendetta. Well, this hospital can't afford to lose me. I've built its reputation up from nothing.
You brought this on yourself. The notes say...
I don't care what the notes say. You're going to pay for this, not me. And as it's going to come down to your word against mine, we all know how that worked out, don't we?
How about explaining why you deemed it appropriate to operate on a patient without permission?
You've been speaking to that blonde nurse. She's got a lot to say for herself. Not every situation requires permission. I took the Hippocratic Oath, vowing to put the care of my patients first, regardless of the consequences to myself.
Miss Jane Williams was not a cancer patient.
Let's not get tangled up in the semantics.
It's a busy department. But there was the usual number of doctors on shift.
She had a suspected tear to the posterior tibial tendon. Her operation wasn't for hours, and I had an opening in my schedule. It was my moral and professional duty to do what I could.
That's what you decided.
I didn't want to go against orders. And the way he was acting, it was just so...
angry. Very angry, I think. He was surprised to see me.
You were very upset.
What he did was...
completely and utterly mindless. Entering during an operation, upsetting the other staff, involving the family, and then admitting the hospital's liability. I mean, I can only conclude that Dr. Malik allowed her personal feelings about me cloud her professional judgment.
There's a lot of history between Dr. Shahzad and Dr. Malik.
The patient would have been fine if Dr. Malik hadn't bulldozed her way into a closed operating theater.
So you're saying she's to blame?
Dr. Shahzad performed an illegal operation without the necessary medical team. The blame lies entirely with him.
Dawn, may I?
I've already recorded your version of events.
Yes. But you don't know the reasons behind them. I've got information for you. It'll explain everything. I appreciate you hearing me out. You're a good friend.
Just doing my job.
Yesterday.
You're not supposed to be here. You're suspended.
You know, it's such a shame you and I can't get on. Especially as we have to work together.
Not for long.
Oh, why? Are you leaving? Oh. You thought I was getting fired?
It was professional misconduct.
Was it, though? Or was it an understandable reaction to months of harassment and false accusations from a colleague?
You're deluded.
Now, I believe the medical term is PTSD. I mean, that's why I behaved so out of character yesterday. Now, fortunately, the hospital have been really supportive, as I'm sure the board tomorrow will be too.
If an employee tells me they're suffering from mental health issues, it's my job to report it. They're entitled to confidentiality.
Confidentiality? Well, yes, we must respect people's human rights.
I am on my way out. I've just got a few loose ends to tie up.
He's not even supposed to be on the premises. He's laughing at you.
I didn't want to upset anyone.
Upset? You think I'm upset?
Maybe we should continue this in my office.
Oh, what a good idea. Shall we?
Don't touch me.
You might fool everyone else, but I know you. Yesterday wasn't about saving some girl. It was about you showing everyone you're a hero. Ali Shahzad, the big I am. And when that didn't work, you started playing the victim.
Well, I've got news. You're not a victim or a hero. You're a rapist. That's enough.
You've already spoken out of turn once to a patient's family.
But go home. I'm only halfway through my shift.
I'm sorry. But you're also suspended until further notice.